Hey, how's it going, everybody? Well, I was hoping to wait, a little bit longer before I added my first edition, but I went to my local LFS today, and they were nice enough to just give me this. I needed this to go on the back of the overflow, just to keep fish and stuff from getting sucked up in the main overflow. So, just out of, I guess, courtesy, I decided to buy a fire shrimp. I've been wanting one for a while and actually got into it with a lady last time I was at the store. I didn't know that she had already previously told someone that she wanted both of the two remaining fire shrimp, and I didn't really hear what they were talking about. They walked away. I went and told someone, that I was gonna get, I just wanted one fire shrimp, and by the time, she was bagging mine up, the lady, raised a ruckus saying that she had already claimed those two. So I said it wasn't a big deal, you can have both of them. The LFS gets them all in all the time. So finally got one today. He's been acclimating for about an hour, drip acclimating for maybe the last 30 minutes. So, oh, and also I went to the store today. He said he's gonna have a huge coral sale tomorrow. So I will probably be picking up some more corals as well as transferring some of the corals from the 8 gallon today. So gonna be trying to do all this in this video. So this is gonna be kind of the all-around new edition video. So here we go. Let's get this new shrimp in here. I've got one of these containers for new fish. Basically it just floats inside the tank. So I was gonna try to transfer the shrimp that way. Turn my drip acclimation off. I use an IV drip. I won this in a contest on a local forum. One of the guy's wife worked at a veterinary clinic, and the prize was this IV drip, and it works great for acclimation. See if you guys can see this, and you can adjust it, and it's very fine tunable, very fine tunable. All right, so here we go. Here's your new home, little buddy. Kind of reluctant to get out of this thing. I'm sure he's scared. Maybe I'll put him closer to the rock. There you go. Man, he's pretty. And what's cool with this rock scape is I have a lot of dark areas. So these are typically reclusive. I'm hoping that since I have a lot of shaded areas, he's going to be a little more active and out in the open. For instance, you can see him. You might be able to see him right now underneath that ledge. Yep. That would be a really cool spot for him to hang out. Or her. I'm not really sure how you tell the difference between the sex on these. I know for sexy shrimp, you can tell by the shell. But I don't know too much about these except for general, shrimp care. Super pretty, super pretty. All right, guys, on to the next one. All right, I've been pretty busy putting in corals after corals, corals. Got my green star polyps back here in the corner. There's a lot of flow right here. So I was hoping they were kind of diffuse it. I think that's why it's still a little cloudy, because it's still sand's still getting adjusted to the flow. So I've got the acans in here, back in the shade. The pagoda cut down there, I moved him. Another echinata, or Ecan echinata. The other ones are Ecan lords. I just moved over the Hollywood stunner, so I've got him in the shaded by that. So some of the euphilias. This thing had this frog spawn has been falling off, so it's not really happy right now. It's not fully extended. There's still not that much flow right here. I did put the rotating high door deflector on there, and so that is adding some random current. It does flow it every once in a while. You can see it right there, starting to get a little bit of current. The tips are still real bubbly. I'm not really sure. So I did my water test today, and the only thing that was really out of whack was my calcium. It was at like 540, something ridiculous high. My alkalinity was a little bit low, like around 8, and my pH was a little low, 7.8. So I opened a window and I added a little bit of pH buffer, not pH buffer, alkalinity buffer. So hopefully that will help a little bit. I'm sure it's also because of the new sand and just everything going on, new environment. So the next one on the list, can't see it because of the light, but these are... Nope, that's the wrong way. Nope, still can't see it. Anyways, a blastomusa. So I was going to post this right here. All you guys saw. It's been drip acclimating. I've just been dripping lots of corals, like the coral. Pretty good. So next, I think I'm gonna start working on getting the zoas moved over. Okay, so I forgot to mention this earlier. This little snail up here, in the 30-gallon, he used to secrete his reproductive stuff, you know. And he's been up on here most of the day, and I think this is also attributing to possibly some of the cloudy water. So I've been debating getting him off, but he's pretty sensitive. I forget the names of them. I think he was a hitchhiker. See, can you see him down there? No, you can't see him down there. I guess that's the only side you can see him, but I think he could be the reason. Anytime I see him up near the return, he's always like stretching his body out, like trying to get into the current as much as possible, and I think that's what he's doing. So I think that could also be contributing to some of the cloudiness. Changed out the filter floss today and added some more carbon. So hopefully we'll get there. I mean, it's only been 2 days, but and it's really not terrible, but I know that it can be a lot more clear. Okay, so finally got all the corals in. Give you guys a quick tour. Start from this side. So I got the acans back there. The green guy has not been super happy. He hasn't really been closing very much, but he hasn't been as open. I'm sure it's just the new environment, you know, the new sand. The tank really probably just needs to settle in for a little bit. Everything else is pretty happy though. Green star polyps, Echinoda, pagoda cup. This thing is very bubbly. I'm wondering why it's different. It was had very long tentacles up until this new tank. Maybe it's the calcium. My calcium is still pretty high, around 540. I did add the DKH buffer, so I'm back up to about 9.5. I feel pretty good there. I don't really want to do too much since it's a kind of a new tank, so I really think I'm just going to let it simmer and do its thing. Kind of keep an eye on all the parameters and just make slow nudges in the right direction. That is the plan, at least. How successful I'll be at that, time will tell. The water has cleared up. I'm still letting a lot of the corals get adjusted to the light. Some of them came from the nano, so they went from 8 watts of LED to, I think this is like 165. Especially all the zoas. It's hard to tell the color in the video. And that one in the back is still a little angry. I had to rip some of them off of the rocks. I didn't want to. I went to go grab my X-Acto knife. The stupid thing rusted shut. I could not get it off. And it broke. So I got angry. And said, oh, I can do it. No problem. Yeah, well, I ended up ripping some polyps off. Blasto garden. Soon to be. I know I've only got a couple. See him back there? More to come. The LFS told me, hey man, I'm getting this awesome coral shipment on Wednesday. You should come check it out. It's going to be amazing. I was like, yeah, cool. Show up on Wednesday. They were there. They were awesome. I said, hey, let me grab this rainbow acan and this rainbow Monty. Oh, sorry. They're not going to be for sale until Friday. It's like, are you kidding me? So I finally complained enough to where they at least allowed me to hold the Rainbow Monty until the sale Friday, which is okay. You know, I think he said he's going to do like a buy one, get one half off, so I'm okay with waiting for that, and at least they set aside the one that I really wanted. So some more additions to come, but this is where we're at so far. I think it's looking pretty good. I plan on doing some SPS at the top. Maybe this is going to be a little torch island. Got to figure out what to do with those euphilias. They got to be somewhere else where they're not going to sting anything and where they have ample room to grow. Maybe they'll just stay on the sand. Who knows? I also added this rock here in the middle. Not sure exactly what yet I'm going to do in that spot. I had both my rotating high door deflectors up there, and with this 1,000 gallon per hour pump, it was just too much pressure. It kept blowing the second one off, so I haven't hooked up the other attachment for that. And but it's okay. I kind of like it more open. It's kind of a more broad current, so it's creating a nice in conjunction with the other rotating deflector. It's a nice turbulence. So. Alright, sorry if this is kind of a long update, but a lot's been going on, so I'll probably do a separate one with the new livestock just to keep this thing short. Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe for updates.